Hello, everyone. Welcome back to the Remember to Live podcast. I'm your host, Corrine Canty. Happy summer. It's midway through the year. It's that time when we all start reflecting on, you know, where, number one, where did the time go? It seems like time is speeding up. Have we done any of the things that we said we were going to do for the year? I know for me, I've been doing a lot of reflection this last week or so, and I realized that I set out at the beginning of the year with a bunch of dreams and goals, some of which I have made a lot of progress on and some have shifted completely. And I realized that's okay because we have to hold space for growth and learning new things and getting new inspiration and realizing some things just don't fit anymore. The one thing that the first half of the year held a lot of for me is events and travel. I did a lot of travel, went to a lot of events, some for fun, some for business, some for just personal development. But this past week, I went to an event here in Atlanta. It was the Coming Home Tour. It was hosted by Robert Hartwell. He was promoting his new show, Breaking New Ground on Max. And when I tell you, it was just a special event. It was a private screening at a local theater here in Atlanta. When I tell you that everyone left that event with a message. The metaphor is just in the first episode alone of what Robert was going through in getting this house and starting renovations were a masterclass on life, in pivoting and the unexpected and perseverance. But the bigger story of renovation, reinvention, it was just such an inspiration. And he called it the Coming Home Tour. And one of the questions he asked us all to contemplate on is, what do we need to come home to? And I've been thinking about that a lot this last week. And I realized I needed to come home to myself. And in thinking about that, I thought about how do we truly become the architects of our own lives? How many of us are just using everybody else's blueprint and not giving any thought into what is really meant for us, aligned with us, what we really like, what brings us joy? How many of us are actually living prescribed, cookie cutter lives? Now, don't get me wrong. You can use everyone else's blueprint for inspiration. I love going to open houses and looking on houses online and looking at how people decorate their homes. And I just take little nuggets of what I like and what brings me joy. And I find my own way to maybe weave that into my own home. And the rest I just leave, right? How do we start to do that with how we build our lives? How do we get present for inspiration, piece by piece, joy by joy, take the little things that fill us up and build our lives? And how many of us look at our lives when it feels like our lives are in shambles, when it feels like everything is breaking down around us, we don't know how we're going to fix any of it? How many of us get ready to just throw that life away, think that there's no solution, think that there's no possible way this life can get any better? And we forget that we can always repaint. We can always renovate a whole room. We can always renovate a whole house. We can get some artwork, throw up some wallpaper, get some new furniture. Sometimes we're so ready to tear down the whole house that is our lives that we don't even try to do the little things that could make all the difference. But also know that you can always just build a new one from scratch, because sometimes we hit that season, we're in life, and we realize, like, you know what? I need a whole new life. And that's okay too. But let's make sure that we've given the one that we already got a chance to reach its full potential, that we didn't just start comparing ours to someone else's and feel like it wasn't good enough automatically and just toss it aside. How do we take agency and ownership and reclaim our lives for ourselves? How do we renovate and rebuild our lives in a way that they bring us more joy, that they bring us more happiness, that we wake up each day feeling purpose and meaning, that we rest our heads each night letting that day go, and feeling fulfilled. And I think the key to us becoming the architects of our own lives is getting really good at designing our days. We spend so much of our life working and planning for some tomorrow, spending 40 or 50 years for a life that we one day will get to live. But life's happening right now in the days. So what's more important than designing how we spend our days? What can make a bigger impact than getting really intentional on how we start our days? When we open our eyes, what's the first thing that we do? How do we set the tone for our days? And getting clear on how we want to spend our days. What are the things we really want to be doing? Who do we really want to be spending our time with? And how do we end our days? How do we let go of the day, get ourselves ready to have some good restorative rest? How do we design our days so there's freedom and openness for experiences that we want to have, for things that we want to learn, for things that we want to do, for who we want to become? So my challenge to you this week is reviewing the blueprint that your life currently is operating from. Who designed that blueprint? Is it the life you really want? Do you need to get some consultants in there to help you rework some things? And by consultants, I mean coaches, therapists, trusted friends, people who can help you see yourself, because it can be really hard to read our own label from inside the jar. It's really hard for us to see our own face without a mirror. It's my favorite part of being a coach, and it's why I always have a coach. I challenge you to start taking stock of how you're spending your days and start taking action on renovating, redesigning, and creating a life that you love. And the perfect question that might help you get started is the one that Robert asked us all this past week. What is it that you need to come home to? I will leave you with that. It's such a deep question. Spend some time on it. Spend some time really evaluating your life. I will leave information in the show notes so you can check out Breaking New Ground as well, because I'm sure that you will be inspired, that it'll make you think. And it's just a great show. Like, if you like home renovation shows, but you also like soul food and things that fill your cup, and the power of family and matriarchs and self-discovery and ancestors, go watch the show and then get to renovating your own life. We have some great guests coming up on the podcast, so stay tuned. If you have not liked and subscribed, please go do so. Until next time, remember to live.